In this tutorial, we are going to see real flow improvements when working with alembic geometries. Let's import an alembic file as multibody. When importing an alembic file as multibody, a single node is imported with all geometries included, keeping the animation embedded. Each imported alembic file has a couple of parameters for better control of the alembic animation. Now we can control the speed of the animation by modifying the alembic speed parameter. We can also control the animation behavior once the animation from the alembic file is over. We can adjust the speed to have different types of animation. Or change the alembic offset to modify the animation. In this way, we can configure different animations with slight changes, modifying the parameters included within the alembic. Let's see how to work with alembic inside a diverso granular scene. Let's generate the cube to be our particle emitter. The size of the cube is not important in this example. Let's duplicate the cube to create a floor. Then, change the cube color to display both in the viewport. Select the box to be used as emitter, and select the fill emitter inside the diverso tab. The selected geometry is going to be included as emitter inside the fill emitter, as well as adding a diverso domain to the scene. Once the diverso domain is created, change the solver to granular. Also change the particle size and the type of particle to be displayed in the viewport. Connect the nodes in the relationship editor, add a hub node and connect the nodes to it. All nodes connected to the hub will be interactive between them. Now, let's create the geometry to keep the particles in. Let's place the geometry to cover the desired area of particles. In RealFlow, now you can remove the particles inside geometries colliding with the fluid. If that option is not active, particles will be created inside the colliding geometry, and this may cause issues in the simulation. To activate or deactivate this option, select the emitter. Then, in the new emission mass parameters, activate or deactivate the From Collisions Objects option. This option indicates that all objects colliding with the fluid will not create particles inside. The isosurface of the geometry defines the collision of the objects with the fluid. Changing the cell size of the geometry also changes the collision mesh with the fluid. Once we adjust the isosurface, the particles inside the geometry are removed. Using the From Objects parameter, we can also set one by one which meshes allow particles inside them. In this way, the newly added cube and the animated geometry avoid a particle overflow. We can see there are no particles inside the spider legs. To control the position of the alembic geometry, add a null and link it to the geometry. If you change the null, you also change the geometry linked to it. Also, when importing an alembic geometry as multibody, we can transform it directly if necessary. In this way, we make the spider a little bigger, and this also affects the particles with which the geometry interacts. Let's set some values for the granular solver. Save the scene. Simulate the scene from command line. Simulating from command line is faster than in GUI. In the simulation options, change the steps in the diverse granular solver parameters. Set 5 for min and max substeps to make the simulation more stable, and set CUDA to make it faster. Once the simulation is done, the spider interacts with diverse particles. In the relationship editor, add a gravity daemon to the simulation. Animate the null position to also change the position of the geometry linked to it. Let's change the spider geometry color. Maybe a black color. That's good. And now we can change the alembic file animation speed. set the alembic parameter to 0.9. Let's show the diversal particles in the viewport and modify the geometry parameters to collide with those particles. Note that the simulation may require more steps. Also, when the geometry is animated, it is a good idea to activate the Use Geometry Velocity option to consider the geometry speed. Simulate the scene. In the preview, watch the spider interact with the diversal particles. With only one alembic file, you can set several configurations for the same animation. It gives you more flexibility. In this way, we can duplicate the alembic file as many times as we want, each one with different configurations, all in the same simulation. Thank you for watching and enjoy RealFlow.